Good morning.
Hi.
Hi. Happy Monday. We hope you had a great weekend. Today we are going to be singing a song called Our God. It's by Chris Tomlin. It has a lot of words that repeat, so hopefully over the next 2 days you'll be able to join us in singing. You can get up and dance along, sing along with us if you want. You girls ready? Mm-hmm.
Water get turned into wine. Open my eyes of the blind. There's no one like you. None like you. Into the darkness you shine. Out of the ashes we rise. There's no one like you. Not like you. Our God is greater. Our God is stronger. God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer.
Awesome and power.
Our God. Our God. Into the darkness you shine. Out of the ashes we rise.
There's no one like you. Not like you. Our God is greater. Our God is stronger. God, you are higher than any other.
Our God is healer.
Awesome and power,
our God,
our God.
Our God is greater, our God is stronger. God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome and power,
our God, our God.
All right, we are doing some stories from Holy Week, the week of Jesus' death. And these stories are kind of long, so a lot of these we're going to be splitting into two parts. So we're going to be doing the first half of A Dark Night in the Garden today. And A Dark Night in the Garden, you can find it in the Bible in Luke 22, Mark 14, and John 18. Could you take that off while we're doing the devotion?
Uh-huh.
Thanks. You can put it on after, okay?
Okay.
So Luke 22, Mark 14, and John 18. We'll be reading the first half today. The wind was picking up now, blowing clouds across the moon, shrouding the garden in darkness. "Stay up with me?" Jesus asked his friends. They said yes and waited under the olive trees, but they were tired and they soon fell asleep. Jesus walked ahead alone into the dark. He needed to talk to his heavenly Father. He knew it was time for him to die. They had planned it long ago, he and his Father. Jesus was going to take the punishment for all the wrong things anybody had ever done or ever would do. "Papa, Father," Jesus cried, and he fell to the ground. "Is there any other way to get your children back, to heal their hearts, to get rid of the poison?" But Jesus knew there was no other way. All the poison of sin was going to have to go into his own heart. God was going to pour it into Jesus' heart. All the sadness and brokenness in people's hearts. He was going to pour into Jesus' body all the sickness in people's bodies. God was going to have to blame his son for everything that had gone wrong, and it would crush Jesus. But there was something else, something even more horrible. When people ran away from God, they lost God. It was what happened when they ran away. Not being close to God was like a punishment. Jesus was going to take that punishment. And Jesus knew what that meant. He was going to lose his Father. And that, Jesus knew, would break his heart in two. Violent sobs shook Jesus' whole body. And then Jesus was quiet. Like a lamb, "I trust you, Papa," he said. "Whatever you say, I will do."
Why did Jesus go to the garden? What did he ask in his prayer?
Why did Jesus go to the garden? Remember the story before this, he had been eating that Passover meal with his disciples, and they got up, he said, "All right, let's go," and he went to the garden. Why did he go to the garden?
Because he wanted to pray to his Father.
Yeah, he needed, good job, Joe. He needed some time talking to God. God the Father is still Jesus' Father, and he needed some time in prayer with him before what was going to happen was going to happen. And then in his prayer, he knew he was going to die. He knew how painful it would be and how horrible it was going to be separated from God. And so in his prayer, he asked if there was another way to save us. He said, "God, if there's any other way, let me do that." But then he also said, "Whatever you need done, God, I will do." So he wanted another way because he knew it was going to be painful, but he also said, "God, I will follow what you want, and I will do what you ask me to do." We are going to share one of our bedtime prayers with you guys. It's kind of like a fill-in-the-blank bedtime prayer. So there are parts of it that I say and then parts of it that the girls help me with. So if you guys want to, we'll do that maybe this week with you, maybe the 3 days this week, and you can learn that with us if you want. You guys ready?
Mm-hmm.
Heavenly Father. Do you want me to do that part? Okay. Heavenly Father, thanks for taking perfect care of us every
day.
Jesus, thank you for dying on the
cross
and taking away all of our
sins.
Holy Spirit, thanks for creating faith in our
hearts
and strengthening that faith every time we hear your
word
and take your
sacraments.
Triune God, please keep us close to you throughout our
lives
so we can live with you forever one day in
heaven.
In Jesus' name we
pray.
Amen.
Amen.
Thanks for joining us. We'll see you on Wednesday.